I've been watching local and state health departments in the last decade or so struggling more and more to meet the needs of modern public health. We now all understand a little better what kind of standards of services for public health health departments are expected to provide for their citizens. And I witnessed how hard it is to reach those standards, especially for smaller units of public health, those in more rural counties or those in very small towns. It's hard to go through all what we call the 10 essential public health services and be able to provide high quality, top-notch services like everyone wants to do when you don't have enough resources to do that. To make things even more challenging, we all know that in the last few years, the budget situation hasn't been very good for local and state governments. And so, on the side of policymakers and public elected officials, there is, I think, more appetite for solutions that could not necessarily cut services, but maybe save a little bit of money, or at least make sure that the money that is invested in our government services is used at the best of its potential and its efficiency. So, when you couple these two things, an increased need for fiscal accountability and perhaps fiscal restraint, and a need for increased level and quality of services, then I think the issue of sharing some of those services becomes more important. Now, the question is how exactly you're going to do it. It's not that simple. Most local health departments are not willing or able or ready to say, we are going to cease to exist and we are going to merge with the health department next door. Nor would that be necessarily the best solution in every case. But probably most health departments will be willing and able and ready to say, let's look into this. Let's consider if there are other options that can make us more competitive and efficient without losing our identity. Do you
Couple
think
things.
that?
I'm in agreement, John Franco, but I would add not a but. I would add a couple of things to that. I think we have to use the term resources in its broadest sense. Too often, we use the word resources and we hone in on the dollars involved. But resources are also the skills, the capabilities, the capacities,
Absolutely.
which are not always readily available or necessarily needed on a full-time basis at the size and scale of all of the health departments we're talking about. So one way of looking at the potential benefits of cross-jurisdictional sharing, and I think some of the driving forces behind it, is a quality improvement approach and a business-like approach to maximize the potential of the resources we do have in ways that meet the respective demands of different jurisdictions. Each jurisdiction may not have a need for a full-time epidemiologist, but all health departments need to have an epidemiologist available to them, if not their own on a full-time basis. How do we make that happen? How do we do that in a context of local autonomy, issues of community ownership, and the like, are some of the challenges, I think, as we look through this. But the idea of resource management, improving the efficiency in ways that also improve the public health effectiveness, is what we're trying to achieve here. I think of it also as a learning organization, the center itself. Yes, we want to be in a position to assist and help the sites meet their goals, move their agenda forward in terms of the sharing models they're looking at. But perhaps more importantly, I think the center has a role in extracting the learning from that, possibly distilling that learning in ways that may be a bit more generic, and then making that available to the public health and policymaking communities at large. So, in a sense, while it's working to the improvement of the selected sites, it should also be working in a way that allows the center to capture that learning, add to that learning from the literature, from other experiences as we become aware of that, in ways that allow the center then to help a broader spectrum of the public health and policy communities than just those 18 sites. So that notion of learning is integral to the design and the
I
way we're
think it's a very important one, Pat. I think one of the fundamental roles of the new Center for Sharing Public Health Services will be that we will be in a unique position to to learn from all the different 18 sites, each of which will conduct their own projects, and they will be in contact with each other, but we will be probably in the best position to really have a global look at this movement throughout the country, learn everything we can learn from each of those sites, and then sharing the knowledge not only among the sites, but to spread the knowledge beyond those 18 sites. And so there will be a spillover effect if our project, as I hope, is successful. They will go way beyond 18 teams throughout the country, but it can reach the public health community at large.
There's a resistance to prescribed approaches. We saw that in part from public health officials. We saw it in part from elected officials. If I'm given an algorithm kind of an approach, you five counties have to join together. And if that's, in a sense, provided top down, it may be resisted on a principle without full consideration of the potential public health merits. But that's driven in part, at least my sense, we have to remember in public health, we've spent the last 20 plus years developing a notion within the public health community of a public health system. And we haven't paid enough attention to the civics environment in which that public health system operates. Most often, local health departments are part of a local government system also. And the actual decision making, that is the authorizing decision to enter into a joint relationship, doesn't rest with the public health official, it rests with the body, the policy-making body, oftentimes an elected body, that has the authority to enter into that. And we have to make sure they're engaged in this in a way that they fulfill their obligations to make sure that they're doing best by their constituency. So that's a piece we're really wanting to pay attention to and think is critical to the success of using cross-jurisdictional sharing, but it's going to be a real centerpiece for this effort.
No, I totally agree. I think one thing I've heard over and over again in the last 10 plus years from especially local health departments is, don't tell us what to do, but help us make a best decision on what to do. And that's exactly what our center will try to achieve. We are not going to be prescriptive in the model. I think we will ask some tough questions. Pat just said, you know, there are roughly 2,700 local health departments in the country. I think it's a fair question to ask. Do we need 2,700 health departments? Can we afford 2,700 health departments? Asking the question is appropriate. What I think is not our role is providing the one answer that everybody will have to follow.